أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ومن آياته أن خلقكم من أنفسكم أزواجا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة، إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. وقال تعالى في مقام آخر: هن لباس لكم وأنتم لباس لهن. وقال تعالى في مقام آخر: وعاشروهن بالمعروف. وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: لم تر المتحابين مثل النكاح، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. صدق الله المولانا العظيم، وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. Honorable ulama ikram, respected brothers and elders, amongst the many signs that reflect the existence of Allah, the being of Allah, proof and evidence about Allah's oneness, Allah makes mention of one particular sign which is common and we witness daily, which is a sufficient reflection of the existence and the greatness of Allah. What is this? Allah says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَدَّلَّ عَلَىٰ قُدْرَتِهِ. Amongst those evidence which indicate and reflect that there is an Allah above us, who is the sole controller. أَنْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. Then He has created for you from amongst yourself, spouse, partner, wife, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا, so that you can derive pleasure out of her, happiness, joy, bliss, solace, comfort, support. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. And via the bond of marriage and nikah, and through the intercession of the oneness of Allah, through the word Allah, when this marriage is solemnized and performed in the masjid, through the barakat and the blessings of that name of Allah, وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. Allah says, He binds this two. And He puts such love, such affection, that the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam substantiates this verse in the following manner: لَمْ تَرَى الْمُتَحَبَّيْنِ مِثْلَ النِّكَاحِ. Nabi alayhi sallam says, you will find many people in this world, many pairs, many couples, many friends, many neighbors, many relatives, two amongst whom there is love, there is concern, there is affection, there is feeling. But you will never find a stronger bond, stronger love and affection existing between any two, as is in the case of marriage when strictly adhered by the divine commandments of Allah and His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Many a times, speaking out of my personal experience, and many other brothers will also bear me out on this point, that prior to nikah, prior to taking this woman in your marriage, few months prior to you processing this proposal, perhaps many of us were ignorant of the existence of a person by this name in this town. That so and so with this name lives in this world, whom Allah has selected as my eternal partner. I never knew that she lived in this world. And many of us will agree with this. 2 to 3 months prior to this nikah taking place. And what was this nikah? It was the intercession of the word of Allah and nothing else. Prior to the name of Allah being mentioned, looking at that woman, the Nabi of Allah said, Al-aynani tazniyan wa zinahuma an-nadhr. The eyes also commit zina. And what is the zina of the eyes? The nasty, the lustful gaze, that is the zina of the eyes. So prior to Allah's name, looking at that woman made me guilty of zina with the eye. To go one step further, prior to the name of Allah being mentioned, to touch that woman, the Nabi of Allah says, on the authority of Maqil bin Yasar radiallahu anhu, لَأَنْ يُطْعَنَ فِي رَأْسِ أَحَدِكُمْ بِمَخِيطٍ مِّنْ حَدِيدٍ خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ أَنْ يَمُسَّ إِمْرَأَةً لَا تَحِلُّ لَهُ. O my Sahaba, it is better for you that a steel nail be driven in the center of your head and the pain be unbearable than you touch the palm of a strange woman. And Allah forbid, Allah protect us, our youth, and the entire ummah, if prior to the name of Allah, fornication took place, zina took place, then the warning is so strong and so severe that the Nabi of Allah says, La yazni zani hina yazni wa huwa mu'min. When that adulterer is committing adultery and fornication, then iman departs both from the adulterer and the adulteress. So prior to the name of Allah, any form of contact with this opposite gender, this girl, this strange girl, was totally forbidden and haram. Now let us just weigh it in the light of the verse of the Quran. And when the name of Allah took place, which is a basic, simple procedure in the house of Allah, immediately after the name of Allah taking place, understand the grandeur. This is what Allah says. It is a sign that reflects Allah's greatness. With the typical situation of Qurbani before us, the situation of Qurbani that is a week ahead of us, if that animal has all the requisites that are required in Shariat, the tail is of X amount of length, the horns, the eyes, the ears, whatever is intact, the knife is sharp, a person slaughters according to the Shari'i manner, all the veins are cut, the blood is oozing, flowing properly as is indicated in Shariat, but intentionally and deliberately Allah's name was omitted, then the Quran says, وَلَا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا لَمْ يُذْكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْقٍ. Every muscle from that sheep or goat or cow, whatever it is, will make, Nabi alayhi salam says, that piece of flesh which is nourished with one muscle of haram is most deserving for Jahannam. And if only Allah's name was taken and that animal was slaughtered, then Allah says, Ya ayyuhar rusul kulu min at-tayyibat wa'malu salihah. Now you go close to that sheep, eat from that sheep and feed. It is my name that will dictate and decide and differentiate. When my name comes, it decides and it dictates. And when my name is not there, after the name of Allah has been taken place, which is sufficient proof of the oneness of Allah, and now this woman comes home, now Allah promises that the bond and the marriage that will come, the link that will come via marriage. Brothers, many of our youngsters are sitting here. Many people today, what the false notion have, that now I'm trying to get to know the girl, and in the name of Valentine's Day, I am sending a gift. How sad, how tragic, how unfortunate, that we have substituted Qurbani, which is a week ahead of us, has left our homes. From the house, it went to the farm, and from the farm, it went to overseas. So on the day of Qurbani, my child gets up in my house knowing nothing of Qurbani. Yet that very same child grows up in that very same Muslim home knowing the reality and the significance of Valentine and birthday parties. And it has gone to such extent and such length that people are phoning ulama and Maulana, I'm having an engagement. I want you to grace the presence. I want you to grace the engagement by your presence in a dua. Are we mocking with the deen of Allah? Something which has no basis, which is inviting the wrath of Allah. From the very word go, many of our children are frequenting these schools. And I say this, brothers, with concern. So what happens on this occasion of Valentine? They receiving gifts from non-Muslim girls. It is very positively interpreted as just a classmate, a friend, a colleague. And then from that it goes on, a closer friend, a relative. And then naturally that relation that started from primary goes on to high. It is more than obvious. Today this boy needs a partner in his life. The girl who brought interest and became important in his life for the last 10 or 12 years. No amount of advice is going to change the mind of this child. The Quran says, وَلَا أَمَةٌ مُؤْمِنَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن مُشْرِكَ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ. That Muslim girl is more better for your son, even if the disbeliever be more striking in her appearance. It's happening, brothers. We turn a blind eye. Tomorrow when the child selects the kafir as his partner, let us not cry. It happened the day we were there. We witnessed it, but we were too naive about it. But rather we initiated it. How immoral a society have we become that the husband comes home boasting about the gifts he has received from strange women, and the wife comes home boasting about the gifts she has received from strange men. Where is the loyalty? Where is the bond? Where is the affiliation? Where is the feelings? What has this marriage created? Where is sukun? لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. Indeed, one cannot deny exchanging of gifts is a wonderful action. تَهَادَوْ تَحَابَبْتُمْ فَإِنَّ الْهَدِيَّةَ تُذْهِبُ وَحْرَ الصَّدْرِ. O my Sahaba, make the giving of gifts a common symbol amongst you. For verily the giving of a gift removes the malice of the heart. But as noble as the action might be it the giving of a gift, which was one of the unique qualities in the life of Nabi alayhi salam, or be it any other noble act, when it comes in resemblance with the enemies of Allah, Allah's qasam, the effect, the significance, the barakat, the mercy of that action is snatched away immediately. In fact, that very same action, as noble as it might be, but because it has been carried out in the spirit of imitating and resembling the disbelievers of Allah, it invites the wrath of Allah. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقولوا راعنا وقولوا انظرنا واسمعوا وللكافرين عذاب أليم. نبي عليه السلام is sitting. His discourses were frequented by his noble companions and likewise many hypocrites, many Jews as well. So the Munafiqeen and the Yahud were noted for their evil conduct and for their cunning habits. And they used to use very ambiguous terms when addressing the Nabi of Allah. So many a times when they wanted to attract the attention of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they used to say Ra'ina. Now Ra'ina in Arabic means, O Muhammad, consider us when you're addressing the audience. But of course, this could only be known or revealed via revelation. They used to stretch it by saying Ra'ina, which meant, Na'uzu billah, according to their language, it meant, O insane man. And in Arabic, it meant Ra'ina, O our shepherd. Sahaba ikram, least realizing the nasty motive of these Jews and Munafiqeen, occasionally when they needed to attract the attention of Nabi alayhi salam, they also happened to use the same word by saying, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, ra'ina, consider us being, you know, unmindful of the evil intentions that the Munafiqeen had. So they resembled the Munafiqeen in one word, in one word. It was enough for Jibreel to descend. It was enough for Allah to give it place in the Quran. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe. If you want to come close to my Nabi and you talk to my Nabi, don't talk to my Nabi in the words of any munafiq or Jew. La taqulu ra'ina. Don't imitate him. The Arabic language is vast. Wa qulu unzurna. Rather say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look towards us. Don't resemble them in the words they use. When Allah, by His kindness, cannot tolerate resemblance in one word. Brothers, what has happened to the ummah that the ummah is going around begging for Western values? You want to give your wife and children? The riwayat of Bayhaqi says, on the 10th of Muharram, open up your doors. Man wassa'a ala iyalihi yawma ashura wassa'a allahu alayhi sa'ira sanatihi. That man who will open up his wallet on the 10th of Muharram and spend on his wife and spend on his children, Allah says, you spend on them and the entire year I will spend on you. What has happened to the ummah that they have become desperate? Allah's Qasam, in whose control is my life, any man going through problems in his marriage, if he bought a Valentine's gift for his wife, that problem, apart from the guna, leave the guna, you know, being extravagant, inviting the wrath of Allah, imitating the kuffar, but on a material, on an immediate effect, it will only exist the uneasiness and the politics that are taking place in your marriage by that gift, by that bouquet of flowers, by that teddy bear. Ajib, I don't even understand how does this explain love. But by that teddy bear or that bouquet of flowers, it will only aggravate and it will intensify. And likewise, that youngster who is delaying the marriage in the false notion of trying to identify this girl, strengthen my bond and my love, Allah's Qasam, it will only aggravate it. And I am not giving this theory on the grounds of theory. I can substantiate it with the cases in which I personally have been involved in, no one else. What happens when nikah takes place? Allah promises muhabbat. Allah promises affection. Allah promises love. Allah promises care. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. Now what happens after nikah has taken place? Allahu Akbar. To look at that woman with love and mercy attracts the mercy of Allah. خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. O my sahaba, the best among you is he who is the best to his wife. Look at it after nikah has taken place. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam told his sahaba, dinarun anfaqtahu fi sabilillah. One is that one rain, listen to this hadith, it is narrated in Muslim Sharif. One is that one rain you spend in the path of Allah. Dinarun tasaddaqta bihi ala miskin. One is that rain or dinar you spend on a poor person. Dinarun anfaqtahu ala raqaba. One is that dinar you spend on the need or setting a slave free. Dinarun anfaqtahu ala ahli. And one is that rain or the dollar, or whatever it is, you spend on the need of your wife. That since I have taken her in my marriage, I am responsible for her needs. And this is what Islam wants, responsibility. Today, unfortunately, the whole system is to shy away from responsibility. So that one rand that you spend on the need of your wife, understanding, kafa bil mar'i ithman, in the riwayat of Abu Dawud, kafa bil mar'i ithman, ay yudayya man yaqud. It is sufficient to render a man a criminal in the eyes of Allah, a transgressor in the eyes of Allah, a sinner in the eyes of Allah, if he neglects the duties of those that he is in charge of. It is sufficient for that man to be to earn the wrath of Allah. Nabi alayhi salam says, from these 5 dirhams that you spend, one on your wife, one on your child, one on your, you know, on a poor person, أَعْظَمُهَا أَجْرًا, the ran that brought you closest to Allah was the one you spend on the need of your wife. In the riwayat of Muslim Sharif, and Allah's qasam, the one you spend on your fiance, on your girlfriend, and on the strange woman is that very same one that will distance you from Allah. Brothers, this is the direct result of the hadith of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. مَا مِنْ عَبْدٍ وَلَا أَمَةٍ يَذْعَنُ بِنَفَقَةٍ يُنْفِقُهَا فِيمَا يُرْضِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا أَنْفَقَ أَضْعَافَهَا فِيمَا يُسْخِطُ اللَّهِ. Whenever any male or female will hoard and mize and be stingy in spending where Allah wants him to spend, Nabi alayhi salam says, the direct effect of that will be that man won't stay in his, that money won't stay in his possession. It will end up that he will spend double that wealth in the places that will earn the wrath of Allah. How many of us, Hajj have become compulsory, we are delaying it. The effect of that is, just as this heart, Allah has made it such, it has to be attached. This is the human nature of this heart. This heart cannot live alone. Allah, in the human nature of man, he wants a partner. If Jannah could not be enjoyed without a partner, how can this world be enjoyed without a partner, brothers? What more can I tell you? If Jannah, the pinnacle of bliss, the pinnacle of joy, the height of happiness, could not be appreciated until Adam was coupled with our mother Hawa alayhi salatu min Allahi wa taslima, how can this world be enjoyed without a couple? So by virtue of this nikah, when there will be strict adherence to this nikah, what barakat will come? رَحِمَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً قَامَ مِنَ. And really, brothers, to be honest, just to slightly digress, apart from the prohibition, really, if you really want to bring a gift home for your wife, not on these occasions that the kuffar have introduced to us. Yesterday, one sister brought it to my note, and these are common things. Manana, when are you going to speak about the husband being more tolerant at home? These are common things. If you ever want to bring something home, the riwayat of Abu Dawood is there. Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu comes home to visit Nabi alayhi salam, and he heard Aisha and Nabi alayhi salam had a dispute. So he got angry and he walks in the house and he's about to slap Aisha radiallahu anhu. That you raise your voice before Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam caught Abu Bakr and he says, you don't touch my Aisha. You don't touch my Aisha. Look at the life of Nabi alayhi salam, the social life of Nabi. Brothers, if you give up reading your papers, you'll have time to read the life of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you give up listening to all your nonsense, then you will have, Allah forgive me, brothers. But really, the whole life, guidance, everything is covered in Quran and Hadith. But it will mean you giving up some other literature that you can touch Allah's Pak Kalam. How sad there are Muslims that are coming and dying, not learning how to read the words of Allah. Never mind understanding the injunctions, but they haven't understood to read the Quran as Allah wanted them to read it. These examples are there in Hadith, but who is there to read it? Where we're reading, it's not there. And where it's there, we're not reading. Nabi alayhi salam caught Abu Bakr. And he says, no, you will not touch my Aisha. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Abu Bakr, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu left. And then after that, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells Aisha, so what you feel about me? I saved you, lucky, eh? If I wasn't there to intervene, you've seen what would have happened to you. So Aisha radiallahu anhu smiled. Anyway, the discussion is patched up. Tolerance. Brothers, that, like I told you, it will never, if you gave it, brothers, make tawbah, go take that gift and throw it away. You are going against the grain, you are going against the system. Your marriage will only see more problems. And those of us that is happening to our children today, let us put a stop with it. Tomorrow when the child is going to look for their partner, either one of the two has to compromise on religion. Either she will compromise or he will compromise. Or on the contrary, both will stick rigid to their religion. The harm is of the generation to come. Your grandchildren will be born as atheists and agnostics, whether you like it or not, brothers. Why? Because the option that child has for the last 15 years, that girl meant something. He brought the gifts of that girl. The mother is keeping relation. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. What has happened to our values? What has happened to Sa'd bin Ubadah says, O Nabi of Allah, if I must walk home, when the verses were revealed regarding zina, and if you see someone involved, then you must bring 4 witnesses. He says, O Nabi of Allah, if I walk home and I see a man interfering with my wife, to be honest with you, with utmost respect, I will not look for 4 witnesses. I will strike that man with the sharp edge of my sword there and then, and I will kill him there. Nabi alayhi salam looked at his sahaba and he said, are you astonished at the sense of honor that Sa'd has? Indeed, by Allah, I have a greater sense of honor than him. And Allah has a greater sense of honor than I. When anyone trespasses the limits of Allah, then just as this one individual is so possessive and protective over his wife, in the very same way, Allah is very possessive over his deen. What will happen through this marriage? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, to bring muhabbat, to bring love, to bring unity. Then few days later, Aisha radiallahu anha, Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu comes back. He knocks on the door, and now he hears Aisha and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam having a casual, informal discussion. So he knocks in and he says, adkhilani fi silmikuma kama adkhaltumani fi harbikuma. Can you people now make me part of your happiness as I had to become part of your arguments? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, come Abu Bakr, you are always part of us. You are always part of us. Tolerance, that will mend that marriage. That will bring love. That will bring muhabbat. In the riwayat of Abu Dawud, rahimallahu imra'an qama min al-layl. Oh may Allah, you shower your choices, blessings and favors on that man who stands up in the night. Tawadza'a, performs wudu. Tawassaka, uses the miswak. And then before communicating with his Allah, he comes to his wife and he taps his wife. The riwayat of Abu Dawud. You want joy, my brother? You want happiness? You want it to be when you go home, all your problems end, that the smile of your wife puts an end to the tension of your day. You are received by a wife that is dressed, prepared, anticipating, anxiously awaiting your arrival, who is there to express gratitude and not demand and accuse and criticize. My Nabi says in the riwayat of Abu Dawud, stand up in the dead of night, perform wuzu, but unfortunately today, that very eye that was to tear before my Allah is now looking at obscene scenes throughout the night. That eye that had the tension, that eye that had the potential of quenching the fire of Jahannam, that eye has now invited the wrath of Allah, that it is increasing and intensifying the flames of Jahannam. That hands that were to beg before Allah, those very hands are touching strange and haram women. That man who stands up in the dead of night, and then he performs wuzu, he uses the miswak, and then he comes to his wife, the words of Abu Dawud, Allahu Akbar. And then he tells his wife, come, he taps her. And she looks at him and she says, oh my beloved, it's 2 o'clock. What are you waking me up for? And she turns the other side. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, this man is standing there, caught up in two situations. He loves his wife, but he loves Allah more than his wife. He loves the sleep of his wife, but he wants iman for his wife more than he wants sleep for his wife. نَضَحَ عَلَىٰ وَجِهِهَا الْمَا. He then takes water, happily and reluctantly. Happily to make his wife understand that these are the moments to speak with Allah. تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا. تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا. Those who separate from their beds and communicate with us in the early part of the morning. Nabi alayhi salam says, نَضَحَ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِهَا الْمَا. As he sprinkles the water trickles down her cheeks. She gets up and she looks at him and she says, what's it? So he says, come my beloved, let us stand up and speak with Allah. This husband, in the dead of night, lifts his wife. And then both with muhabbat and affection, sacrificing their sleep, when the entire creation is fast in sleep, when some are in zina, some are consuming wine, some are enjoying strange women, this couple stand up in the dead of night, and then they perform wuzu in the prescribed manner, apply use the miswak, and then the husband performs salah, and the wife says ameen. The wife makes dua, and the husband says ameen. My Nabi has made dua for this husband, this wife. When my Nabi has made dua for a couple, brothers, there's nothing that can demoralize or affect that marriage. There's nothing that will bring you more happiness, more joy, more love, more bliss, more cooperation, more understanding than these guidances which is given to us by our spiritual guide and our master. We make dua to the Almighty Allah. He instilled within us these noble characters, these noble qualities, and may Allah give us the tawfiq. Indeed, these 10 days were the days when the Quran takes an oath about it, speaking about resemblance, brothers. Just as bind that gift to resemble on the wrath of Allah, we have been taught in these 10 days not to clip our nails, not to trim our hair in resemblance of those pilgrims that will be congregating on the Maidan of Arafah in the millions, in resembling them, nothing else. I'm not there, I'm not in ihram, I'm not a muhrim. But my Allah has told me, when the moon of Zilhijjah has been sighted, when the crescent of Zilhijjah has been sighted, then create a resemblance with those pilgrims that will congregate. Who knows when my mercy will come down, which knows no bounds. Anyone and everyone having the least form of resemblance with those pilgrims will also be uncovered in the forgiveness and pardon at that moment. We make dua to the Almighty Allah. He give us the ability to imitate and emulate the chosen patient servants of Allah, the guidance servants of Allah. And may Allah protect us, our spouse, our partners, our children from following Western values and systems. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.